Take a risk. Take a chance. Take a dare. Play the game of Double Dare. With the host of Double Dare, Alex Trebek.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Nice to have you joining us once again on Double Dare. We're going to have a lot of fun in the next half hour. I'm going to start things off right now by introducing our contestants. Gene, if you would.
First, here's our returning champion, Lee Baird.
Hi, Lee. How are you feeling today?
I feel great. Fantastic.
Lee Baird is our champion here. He's an ice cream man, and he moved into a higher tax bracket on our last show because in just 30 minutes, he wound up winning $5,500, which is pretty good going. And now he gets to defend his title against this individual. Let's meet your challenger.
Challenging Lee is Julie O'Neill.
Hi, Julie.
Hi, Alex.
You have a pretty smile.
Thank you.
You told me on the last program when we introduced you that you were studying for the ministry, right?
For the priesthood, right.
For the priesthood. Now, what religious denomination?
It's, you wouldn't know if I explained it to you. It's the Church of Gnosis. It's a very ancient church.
Mm-hmm.
Goes back.
Now, once you are ordained, how would you be addressed? You wouldn't be addressed as father, obviously, or would it be reverend or what?
Yeah, reverend.
Reverend? Okay, how much time before all of this takes place?
Hopefully only 2 months.
Okay, do you need a lot of cash to help put you through school and various things
like
that?
Well, not to help put me through school, but to help us find a new church. Because we're being thrown out of where we are.
A lot of people who have started religions have run into similar difficulties, believe me.
Right.
But you're doing well. You're leading in this game. When we left off on our last show, you had accumulated $350 in cash, and that goes up on the board. And our champion, Lee Baird, has yet to earn a penny, so you might well become our new champion. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
I'll remind our viewing audience that a game is $500. We show the players clues one at a time to help them identify a person, place, or thing. And the first one to buzz in with the right answer wins $50 and gets the right to make a dare. Now we're going to start off by showing you folks at home the right answer. So if you'd like to play along with us, don't look at your television screen until you hear the ping. Here's the right answer for our first subject. And players, the first subject is an activity. An activity. Good luck. First clue coming up for you. The Daily Worker called this a capitalistic cancer, a product of the profit system.
Yeah.
No answer yet. Let's go on to clue number two. Governor Earl Long brought JFK and Jackie to attend one. And Julie thinks she knows the answer.
Horse racing.
No.
Oh.
No. So we close you off, Julie, and we bring Lee back. She came up with the wrong answer, Lee, so you know what that means. A penalty clue for you to look at, and we'll give you a free guess also. Here it is. Clue number three. Dove's Mexican hat have all been occasionally used in this. What's the activity, Lee?
How about a bullfight?
Bullfight? No, you are wrong. Incorrect answer from you, but you have one advantage over Julie. She will never get a look at that clue. Let's bring her back, and we'll continue the game. We're going on. Still no right answer. Here's the next clue for you. When the reverend of a church asked members to share their talents, member Diana King did this for 125 members. Lee buzzes in. What's the answer?
A belly dance.
Belly dance is wrong. So we close you off. We bring Julie back. He gave us an incorrect answer, so we get a penalty clue for you to look at, and you'll get a free guess. Here's clue number five. One exponent of it said, you gotta leave them hungry for more. You don't dump the whole roast on the platter.
A barbecue.
When you hear the right answer, Julie, you'll know why the audience is laughing over a barbecue. That is wrong. Again, you have an advantage in that Lee will never see this.
Okay.
Let's bring him back. Still no right answer. We're going on. We're having fun with this one. Let's go on to the next clue. It was noted that early variations of this caused audience members to bring opera glasses and pocket telescopes. And now Julie buzzes in again.
A striptease?
You're right, yes. Took us a while, but you came through and you now have $400, and it's a dare situation for you, Julie. I'll explain why this is very important for you in a moment, but first let's look at the clue. Professionals in this activity refer to themselves as artistes, and on theater programs, this is billed as the specialty. Now, you have, at this moment, $400. This is the dare clue. If you take the dare, show it to Lee, and he doesn't get the right answer, you will win $100, and that means you'll have a total of $500. You'll be the new champ, and you'll get to play the spoilers for $5,000. What are you going to do?
I'll take the chance.
Why not? Everybody else agrees with you. Let's bring Lee back. Julie gave us the right answer, Lee. She's taken the dare. If you want to stay alive in this game, you're going to need to come up with a right answer. Okay. Here is the clue for 5 seconds. What's the activity, Lee?
Striptease.
You are right, and you've got $50, and you've managed to hang on. All right, $400 for the challenger, $50 for the champion, and we're going to continue this exciting game right after this break. For commercial world entry.
In game show history, Who's Who's debuts and is gone after one episode when sponsor General Mills pulls the plug. I've Got a Secret premieres with Gary Moore, and Steve Harvey wins an Emmy for Outstanding Game Show Host on Family Feud.
A lot of the subjects on Double Dare are persons, and our next subject is a person, but before we show you people the clues, we want to show our home audience the right answer, so they'll know what you're looking for. Ready? Here we go. Clue number one. Doors open and we find every morning two detectives tailed him on his way to work. Clue number two. Although scornful of yippies and hippies, he was a defense witness at the trial of Tom Hayden and Abby Hoffman. Number three. He once complained bitterly, "They have vilified me. They have crucified me. Yes, have even criticized me." Julie.
Mayor Daley?
You're right. For $50, that's gone. Hey, you're doing fantastically well on Double Dare.
Thank you.
And it's a dare situation for you, and you've got $450. Here's the clue. Some lip-reading television watchers claimed he shouted obscenities at Senator Ribicoff at the 1968 Democratic Convention. Now, what are you going to do with that?
I don't think I'm going to dare on that one.
No?
No.
I think he's going to get it.
All
right, let's bring Lee back. Stop here. Julie got the right answer. She's up to $450, but she has not taken the dare. She thought this clue would give it to you. Some lip-reading television watchers claimed he shouted obscenities at Senator Abe Ribicoff at the 1968 Democratic Convention. What would your answer have been, Lee?
My only guess was Timothy Leary.
Oh, no. Mayor Daley of Chicago. So, Julie,
well,
a dare that was not taken there and should have been, and you'd have wound up the new champion. But you're very close. You're just one correct answer away from relieving Lee of his title. Let's see if it happens on this next subject, and we'll show the folks at home the right answer. This time our subject's a person. First clue. Of his college classmates, Patricia Neal, Charlton Heston, and Jeffrey Hunter, only he went on to specialize in comedy. Next. According to TV Guide, he's a worrywart, assailed by self-doubts, convinced he is both unattractive and unfunny. Lee buzzes in fast. What is it?
Danny Kaye.
You are wrong. Danny Kaye is an incorrect answer, so we close you off and we bring Julie back. Lee came in fast there on clue number two, but he gave us a wrong answer.
Good.
Now you get a look at the next two by yourself. Okay. We'll give you a free guess, and if you're right, you're the new champ. It's as simple as that. Here it is. In one Broadway show, he got laughs when he hobbled on stage with one arm holding a crutch and the other in a sling. Julie, the championship is yours if you can give me the right answer.
Jerry Lewis.
Wrong answer. Wrong answer. Lee will never get a look at this clue, however, so let's bring him back, and we'll go on to another clue. Still no right answer, Lee. You're alive. Clue number four. Asked on a television game show why motorcyclists are partial to leather, his reply was, "Because chiffon wrinkles so easily." Next, clue number five. He played the same role in the stage and screen versions of Bye Bye Birdie, and he stopped the show singing Kids. Julie, for the championship.
It's Dick Van Dyke. I know
Julie,
what I did.
It's not Dick
it's
Van Dyke.
It's not Dick Van Dyke.
So we close you off. We bring Lee back. She gave us a wrong answer. You get a look at the next clue all by yourself, and we'll give you a free guess, Lee. His basic comedy character has been described as a manic fuss budget, and he's not that different in real life. What's your answer?
Dick Van Dyke.
Dick Van Dyke is incorrect. All right, we're going to continue. Let's bring Julie back. Still no right answer. We're going on. Next clue. He was one of Broadway's new faces of 1952, along with Eartha Kitt and Carol Lawrence. And I bet even without turning around that that's Julie's buzzer. And the answer for the championship is...
It has to be Paul Lynde.
It is Paul Lynde. $500 to Lee Paul Lynde was the right answer. You were very close with Dick Van Dyke. You're going away from Double Dare with a lot of fives. $5,550. Congratulations, Lee. Goodbye. And congratulations to you, young lady. Oh, how did you feel after you said Dick Van Dyke and knew it was wrong?
Stupid.
Well, you're not going to feel stupid in the next part because we're going on to play the spoilers for $5,000 after these commercial words. Stay tuned, folks. We're back right after this on Double Dare.